We've been in Maine for 4 or 5 weeks now.
Five.
Started in Millinocket, went to Bangor, then up to Lubeck, then down to Bar Harbor, and then finally down to Kennebunkport.
Right.
Overall, Maine was very rugged.
That's a good word. The coast is very pretty.
The coast is. The inside, not so much. We didn't have great experience in the interior.
Yeah, it's pretty, but it's not. It's nothing that really stands out from anything else that you could see somewhere else. The coastline is more unique.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Acadia was beautiful. Lubeck was, I think, even better.
Yeah.
If you want something very laid back with views, amazing culture and history, then Lubeck is the place to go. But yeah, Kennebunkport, there wasn't much here. The coast is mainly houses. The bush compound thing is here.
Right, the Bush family.
We tried to stop by there, but there was tons of people along the road taking pictures. Downtown Kennebunkport is very small. There's not very many shops.
It is small. It's super cute.
It is very cute. Lots of like history plaques and with the harbor and the past bridges and stuff that were around here. It was really cool. It was just very busy every time that we went down there.
Right.
And it's the off season too.
It's not a touristy attraction kind of place.
Right. There's no big box stores. There's no theme parks. There's no anything like that.
Right.
So just a place to be. So excited for the locals. They have an amazing, beautiful place.
Oh, for sure.
All that to say, we did find one cool, interesting thing to do. The Seashore Trolley Museum. We looked up this museum. We had it tagged. We didn't look too much into it. We didn't know what to expect when walking into this thing. It was relatively expensive to get in. It was like $50. It was 100% worth it.
It was. Because when you walk in, you don't really know. You see buses and parts of trains. And so, you know, what is this museum exactly?
I guess people go there for the pumpkin patch. And then they pay money to ride on the trolley to the pumpkin patch. But you can walk around this place and check out all the vintage trolleys from like the 1900s.
Right.
Complete with like velvet seats. And it was a trippy, bizarre step back into time.
It was.
Some of these things were just amazing.
From 1900.
Oh my goodness.
You know, some of it from other countries.
Yes.
That's been brought in.
Yep.
It was amazing. And, you know, the guy was like, just wander.
Have an open mind.
Right, because you don't know what you're going to find when you go out there. And the more you walk and the more you look and you kind of snake in between these buses and trolleys.
And go inside of them and you kind of pry the doors open. Not sure if you're going to supposed to be in some of them, but all kinds of old Greyhound buses and some of them have leaves in them. Like they're just exposed to the elements.
Yeah, well, some of them had old newspapers still in the front.
The old vintage like ads.
Oh yeah, along the top of above the seats and the buses.
Amazing history and step back into time.
Yeah.
The people that work there or run the place are very knowledgeable.
Oh my goodness.
They have a whole restoration building and one of the gentlemen was in there working and he answered like a ton of our questions.
Yeah.
Like all kinds of crazy facts. Like it takes up to 10 years to restore one of these trolleys.
One of them specifically that they were working on, they were actually getting funding for that one.
Yep.
They had another one kind of back in the corner, and that one was solely based on volunteer hours. And that one had been sitting there, I think he said, since 1986. Still being worked on.
They get all their money from grants and from the government if there's like a storyline behind it. He was also telling us that it takes like up to $1 million that they can spend on restoring one of these things. 20 to 25,000, I guess, man hours. It is impressive the amount of time and effort they put into restoring these things bit by bit.
Right.
All from photographs.
You have kind of basic knowledge. Once you figure out one of them from that time period, you can kind of carry that information and that knowledge forward onto the next build. The man hours, the hunting, the know-how to track this information down.
Yeah, so he's like mostly detective, finding old paint chips and then using that to go off to the stuff. So it was very interesting to hear the backstory and the history behind what it takes to restore one of these trolleys.
Right.
We highly recommend stopping by this place. Your money for the ticket goes to restoring these things. There's lots of history there. It's kid and dog friendly, the whole place. So definitely go and stop by. It's worth your time.
Yeah.
Base camp for the week. Sandy Pines Campground in Kennebunkport, Maine. I think this was probably, what did we decide? This is the nicest campground that we've been in?
I think so. It's hard to tell for sure because we are here in the off season and this place has been empty.
It's amazing when there's nobody here.
Fantastic. So do we love it because there's nobody here? Or do we love it because it's really that amazing? I don't know.
Yeah.
And the way they have the sights all angled, they're all angled just a little differently. You're not in a big row.
Right.
So you're turned like just enough to where you're kind of in your own little bubble.
$65 a night. So it was kind of pricey. But I think for what you're getting, I think it's worth it.
And where you
it.
Are, you know.
You have the laundry. You have a nice little store up front that they sell like ciders and little alcohol and stuff. So,
and you know, basic camping things, propane and magnets and stickers and shirts and
They have a huge like glamping area that which is like they have like canvas tents. They're wooden, they're covered in canvas, but they're really posh looking.
They are, they're really cool.
Very Instagrammable. Got the lights hanging down. With the leaves on the ground. It's finally looking like fall here.
And they've all got cute little seating areas outside around the fire pit. They've done a really nice job putting this together.
They have. So they have some kind of strict rules. Like, your fires must be out by 11. There's no motorbikes, no golf carts. There's no drones. So you're not going to see any footage of that here. But yeah, it puts you in great proximity to see the nothing that there is to see at Kennebunkport.
You know?
If you're going to come here and spend time at Kennebunkport, this is the place to do it. So no complaints from us. 5 stars.
Yep.
That's it. Last stop in Maine, Kennebunkport Seashore Trolley Museum. From here, we are headed to Salem to check out the whole Halloween witch thing. Really looking forward to that because Parker's still at a young age. He's only 10. So I'm excited for him to kind of get around all this and see what Salem has to offer.
Yeah.
And then we're headed to Virginia, then back into Boone, and then south, and then back west. And thanks for joining us on all of our adventures. If you like this video, go ahead and give us a thumbs up, and we will see you next week.